Right, boys, it's been an amazing few months for you.
Fantastic.
Second album has topped the Irish and UK charts.
Mm. Yeah.
Number two in Australia, three in the States.
Yeah.
What a year. Record-breaking ticket sales, including 302s, your hometown. Mm. And Viva Stadium, 50,000 people.
It's all mad, gone.
Unbelievable. What's it like to be the script?
Do you think you were at the Sugar Club? When we played the Sugar Club, you think of that? Probably about 50-something people, I think.
Well, you sold 28 tickets for the first and 36 for the sixth.
I know, yeah, and we're not messing around because he was actually the one who sold the tickets.
That's
so, 28 tickets.
The funny part about it is I think they were all probably to family and friends.
They were. It's true.
22 each.
Yeah.
To answer your question, though, it's been a fantastic 2 years, you know, where you kind of gave off the match of the day highlights, you know, that we'll be doing this year alone. But it's been like that every year. You know, last year was the likes of Support and Take That and Crow Park, Paul McCartney, you two. But for us, it was, you know, people were asking us, what are you going to do after that? Yeah. And for us, doing it ourselves was the big one. You know, trying to headline these festivals, trying to, you know, do our own Aviva show and trying to really give people decent value for money. You know, obviously times are hard as well, but give, you know, keep ticket prices low, but put the best show that an Irish band could possibly put on nowadays.
Yeah. But I remember it was one of my best moments was when the last time you played Oxygen, I think, was it Man Who Can't Be Moved?
Yeah.
That you started and the crowd just took over.
There was a moment there, I think, for Oxygen, for us, it was the big doubtful moment for us as a band as well, because we were coming back and we'd also known that there was other people playing on the other stage, you know, against us, because usually that's the problem, there's a good band playing and you think everybody's going to go see that band.
Yeah.
But I think what was mad about the day of Oxygen for me is that we didn't know there was live video feed on each side of the screen, people watching us backstage. We didn't know that at the time. We were so focused on doing the gig, I didn't even see the cameras, to be honest with you. But then it was only afterwards when somebody handed me a DVD of it that I looked and I saw it before we walked on that we were all nervous and crapping ourselves backstage. And it was only when I realised that I think everybody started to get with us and with us and with us, because they realised that we're obviously three very normal lads about to go out to 70,000 people or whatever. And I do remember when you talk about Man It Can't Be Moved as well, is that the record company actually insisted that we wouldn't play that song on the festivals. And that song. Yeah, they insisted that. We were talking to Simon last night about this.
Yeah.
And they insisted that we wouldn't play it because they just said, it's not a festival song, what are you doing? And when, as you say, we went out and played it and it couldn't have gotten a bigger reaction. It was actually so strange.
Unbelievable. Mm. So here we are, you're dressed in Killarney. You've been rehearsing hard the last few weeks.
Yeah.
It's. Are you excited to be back on the road?
Honest to God, I think we miss being on the road more than we do being off it. When you get off the road, I'm just waiting to get back on the road again. I think we feel more at home on the road than we do off it. Now, we spent the last, 3-4 years now?
Yeah.
Touring constantly, non-stop. So when you get a bit of a break at Christmas time, which is when we get a break, and you go home, I know myself, within 2 weeks, I'm ready to go back out again.
It's a different it's a different set of skills that you have and that you learn. Like Liam Neeson in that movie, you know. I developed very serious skills.
Yeah.
I developed over a four-year period.
Yeah.
But I love being out on the road. You know, to me, that's where everything connects, you know, when our music connects with the audience. You know, the reason why we do this, and definitely why I do this, is to connect with people.
And the love you get, the love you get from the audience every night. I mean, you're walking out there to like thousands of people all sending love and energy in your direction. And they're all waiting for you to get out there. And the lights go down and the intro kicks in. There's nothing like that feeling.
I think we as a band as well do something quite different than most bands. We have a little stock taking list in our heads. It's not something that we actually literally write down, but I think we should really, really, really remember that it's not about 10,000 people or 15,000 people. We really see the audience each as one person. And you try to think to yourself, they have left work probably today early to come see us. Yeah. They've had a few drinks before they come out to see us. I kind of imagine their journey to the show almost, and I imagine personally when I'm out there I really do think of everybody as individuals.
Yeah, and money's hard enough to come by these
days. It really
days,
is so. And the fact that people put their hands in their pockets to spend on the script is a really humbling feeling. It really is. Yeah. It's a very strange, because I'm a music fan and I do that for my favourite artists.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think when we play I think we can't help but be grateful the fact that people are doing that for us, because again, we've been unsuccessful for longer than we've been successful.
Yeah.
So we, I think we really, really feel that when we go on stage every single time, but you can't help it because the audience are just brilliant enough for us.
Yeah.
The reason why people got into us in the first place was we used to make places like the Sugar Club feel like an arena. You know, we used to make those places feel like, oh, you're literally, you know, I can imagine these songs in a bigger platform, a bigger area, a bigger place. And finally getting the opportunity to do that, we didn't want to lose what we had before, which was being able to see the whites in people's eyes. You know, the connection is what we keep going back to, the connection and the honesty. We don't want to lose that, you know, so we've been messing around with some ideas on how to, I'm not going to give them away now, but on how to actually get us more connected with the audience, you know. The usual, obviously, going through the crowd, but, you know, we want to come up with two or three possible different ones that are really going to bring this script right into the centre of things, so people don't feel like they're too far away at any given time, you know.
For those of you that don't know us, we are the Script from Dublin, Ireland. This song is called Break Even. I know you know, sing along.
We're up there having a mad buzz between the three of us, three lads, and you can see that every time. The connection that we have on stage is so important. It is the show. Yeah. There's no light, sound, anything that can emulate that, you know. Because this was really where the success story for the Script really kicked off, was Ireland. That was the spark, you know. And I think when we saw our music working in a country that we were from Ireland, but no one knew we were Irish, you know what I mean? Our music doesn't sound very Irish, so I think everybody thought we were Americans coming to Ireland. I think everybody, you know, and I think everyone was slightly confused, because at that point, no one gets a chance to talk to you. They just hear your music first, and that's all, which we loved. But the battle we had here in this country to let people know that we were actually Irish and born and bred in James Street, by God's sake, you know, was a big one. And once we did that and seen that it worked here, we couldn't understand why that wouldn't work anywhere else. If Irish people get it, then I know the rest of the world will get it. Yeah. So it was very important when we went to America to stay true to those roots, because had we changed the broth at all, it was spoiled, you know. And the whole point was to take what we do and let people see it first, let them make their mind up. So record companies and everyone else, sometimes, while I love them and our record company are brilliant with us, they want to check all the correct boxes and they want to make money, and this is their job in that way. But and our job is to make sure the honesty and who we are as a band is never changed and never touched, you know.
Yeah, true, yeah. Mm. Well, they've done a good job as well.
Thanks.
Tiny Temper, on the back of his success at the Brits, is supporting you on the tour. Yeah, how did that all come about?
It came about through, I guess, a mutual respect. We took a Tiny Temper song written in the Stars, his first single. We were asked to do a Live Lounge cover version, and we were listening to all the songs on the radio at the time, and his seemed to be, you know, one of the hottest that was out at the time. So we took it, and in learning a song, you get a real respect for an artist, you know, learning his lyrics, learning his melodies, learning everything. He was kind of our first choice. We were like, look, I think it'd be great to offset what we are. We're having Tiny on before us, you know. So I think our fans are going to get a real treat that day as well, you know. And then he's an artist at the top. He's right on the rise now as well. It's funny enough, by that time, who knows, we'll actually be supporting him, you know.
But he said he wants to collaborate with you. Is there any plans?
No plans right now, but again, you can never say never.
Okay. Mm. So there could be a possibility you might come on stage at Auction.
Well, and the funny thing is,
it could be,
so we do know a song, so.
I have a message for the Oxygen crowd, and it's I just hope if you give us a quarter of the response that we got from last year when we played, we'll have a fantastic night. So please just come up and bring your lyric books, because it's going to be one hell of a sing-along. You know, as I think we connect with the Oxygen crowd, because I was in the Oxygen crowd, you know what I mean? I've been going to those festivals since Fela back in, you know, Trip to Tip and stuff. So it comes full circle. You know, I think that's what everybody's seen with us when we were standing on stage. Like, you know, I know there was people in the crowd that day going, I can do that. Yeah. He's from my area, yeah, you know, yeah, and just, yeah. Like, you spark up, I don't know, someone's imagination.
I think it does, you know. I think what we've got is, with the Oxygen crowd, we've got the fact that we are actually Irish and we're playing main stage. Mm. And the amount of Irish fans that are going to be there that day is just, for us, a very, very magic thing, you know. So it just feels like we get a chance to play to a festival crowd, and there's nothing better than a festival crowd. A lot of times they come with a big tribal mentality. So like Glenn says, festival crowd at home, Oxygen, seriously,
you can have other giant bands, you know, it's always, you can have big bands that are on, but when it's your own band, you know what I mean, when it's homegrown talent there, it just, it really riles it up, you know.
Even for us, there's a big sense of pride to step out onto that stage, and you know you're getting out in front of your own, you know, your own country, to get out there and actually feel that energy. It's going to be unbelievable. Now I'm trying to make sense of my little remains.
Oh, you left me with no love, with no love to my name. Well, we're really excited to have you back.
Thanks for having us back.
Yeah. Yes,
seriously.
Thank you.
Honestly, it's brilliant. I can't believe
you.
Guys.
The best of luck over the next few months.
Thanks very much, brother man.
See you, boys. Nice to my first interview over
We'll get you a good table at Nappy now. I'll give you a badge now. Still a lap on a penny.